In this video, we're going to take a look at the modulator types. The modulators have been added to insert movement to the sound and create interesting results. Firstly, let's look at the envelope. The envelope allows you to shape the overall loudness or timbre of the sound. It can be patched to all destinations on the matrix, including destinations you create yourself. On the MicroFreak, Arturia has also included a cycling envelope. This acts differently to the standard envelope in that it re-triggers itself after the last stage has finished, making it a complex LFO capable of creating wave shapes that can't be created by a standard LFO. The LFO on the MicroFreak has 6 different types of waveforms, and by using the matrix, it can be assigned to pretty much anything to create sounds with a whole lot of movement. Just select shape to hear the different waveforms in action. Pressure. This one is quite fun because it uses the PCB keyboard. You can assign the pressure applied to the keys to control various parameters. We'll take a look at how to do this shortly. To browse the connections, just turn the matrix knob and you'll see the light moving along, left or right, depending on the way you turn it. To create a connection, select what you would like to assign, push down on the matrix selectable switch, and the connection is made. Now set the amount. The matrix settings can be positive or negative. Here I'll assign the cycling envelope to control the wave. This is the effect. To quickly erase the connection, either turn it to zero or hold down the matrix selectable switch for a while to disconnect it. The final 3 destinations are quite special. We've left it up to you to define destinations for them. This is a feature on the Matrix Brute that we've included in MicroFreak. Let's say you want to modulate the shape of an oscillator with the LFO. Wave and timbre are already fixed destinations on the matrix, and shape is not. So we move the matrix to LFO and assign 1. Push the select knob. Then hold down assign and turn shape. As you can see in the display, it is now assigned. Go back to the matrix to set the amount and it's all done. There are a lot of parameters that can be assigned in this way. Refer to the manual for the full list. You can even modulate the glide amount, for example. The utility function allows you to assign additional roles. Here you can adjust the keyboard follow, the LFO retrig and envelope reset, preset volumes, MIDI and sync options, keyboard sensitivity, and many more. From what you've seen here, MicroFreak is far from being a one-trick pony synth. You can do a crazy amount of modulation assignments to make your own sounds, from the beautiful to the completely weird. In the next episode, we'll look at the keyboard and arpeggiator and how it adds to the feature set of MicroFreak.